sixth graders. So we are continuing our journey around ratios. And now we're going to look at how do ratios form a proportion. So yesterday we were looking at unit rate, getting our denominator down to one. And then the day before that, we learned how to make ratio tables. So we're going to continue to use our ratio tables. Well, we did use our ratio tables to see what the equivalent ratios were as we were working through these problems. So we said that we use ratio tables to find equivalents, to organize ratios, and to help us solve. And so as we're looking at our work here, we're going to use this idea around ratios and equivalent ratios to talk about proportions. So first of all, what does that word like even mean? Like that's a weird word. Proportion? Like that's a funky word. Well, proportions are equations that have a value where the two ratios are equal. Okay, so their value is equal or equivalent. So a proportion a proportion happens when an equation states that the values of the ratios are equivalent or equal. Okay, they're equal to one another. So that is what a proportion is. It's a way for us to check to see if our two compared ratios are equal. And it's their value, it's the outcome. All right, ready? Let's move along. We know equations have an equal sign. So it's important for us to remember that equations have equal signs. So we're going to be using those equal signs. For some reason, my lamp is off. So I'm going to turn my lamp on so that you can see the work a little bit easier. All right. So example A. Let's just jump right into this and see what is a proportion and get some examples of this. How do we even solve? So we have two ratios, 6 to 4 and 8 to 12. And we want to know, do these two form a proportion? That means, do they make a ratio that has a value that is equal? So that's what we're looking at. Do their ratio values, are they equal to one another? That means that they are proportionate. Okay, so let's look and see what we do. So we're gonna take 6 to 4 and we're gonna turn this into a fraction. So instead of writing the ratio this way, we are gonna turn it and write it like this. Now what we're going to do is we are going to find an equivalent ratio that is simplified. So simplified down, and we're going to divide this by 2, because if I divide by 2 over 2, that gives me a denominator that is the smallest it can go. So 4 divided by 2 gives me 2, and 6 divided by 2 gives me 3. So the smallest fraction that this can be when it's reduced down, simplified, right? So simplifying is 3 over 2. Now, I know that this looks weird as an improper fraction, but I want you to keep it like this because we're going to compare it to this one. And so it'll be really easy for us to compare when it still looks like this fraction. Okay, so let's look at 8 to 12. So we have this fraction now, I mean this ratio, 8 to 12, that we need to turn into a fraction. So 8 over 12, and we need to divide this into the smallest possible fraction. So the smallest we could divide by is 4. That will give us a denominator of 3. 3 is a prime number, so we know that that's the smallest it can go. So we're going to divide by 4. And if I divide by 4 on the bottom, I have to do it to the top so that they are equivalent. Okay, so 8 divided by 4 gives me 2, and 12 divided by 4 gives me, 3. That's a 3. Okay, so we have 2/3, and that one has 3 over 2. This is not proportionate. So this is not proportionate. And the reason why proportion... Okay, so it's not a proportional relationship because these two ratios are not equal. 3 over 2 is not equal to 2 over 3. So they are not the same. Their values are not equal, so they're not proportional. Okay, let's do another one so that we can see one that is proportional. All right, so let's do 10 to 18 and compare that to 45 to 81. All right, so our first step, remember, is to turn these into fractions. So let's take 10 over 18. And we need to find the smallest number that 18 can go into that is a prime number. So I don't know, let's go right away and just divide by 2. So I'm gonna divide by 2 over 2, and that gives me 5/9. Okay, and the reason why I chose 2 was because I could tell that both of these were even. I was thinking 3, but 3 can't go into 10. Like 10 can't be divided by 3. And then I also thought about 9 because 9 is another prime number, but it can't be divided by 9, 10. So I couldn't do 9 divided by 9. Instead, I had to do 18 divided by 2, so I got to 9. Okay, now let's do the other one. So our other ratio that we're looking at is 45 to 81. So 45 over 81. And I want to see, is there a way that I can get 81 smaller? Well, yeah, right? Like 9 times 9 is 81. So I'm going to divide this one by 9. And I know that 45 can also be divided by 9. And so I get 45 divided by 9 is 5. 81 divided by 9 is 9. Now we're going to compare. So we're going to compare this and this. And I get an equal, right? So because their values, when they're simplified, are both 5/9, that means that they are proportionate. They're proportionate. They are equal. So these ones do form a proportion. So this is, yes, proportional. Now we're going to change, I'm going to turn the page so that we can look at using a ratio table. So now we're going to use a ratio table to see if two ratios are proportionate when we're using the table. So let's look at... X I'm gonna draw the table a little bit different. It's still the same thing, but we're gonna draw it going down this time. You can draw it going across if you want, but when you draw it, it's the same. So X always comes first. So on the top would be X, the bottom would be Y if you were drawing your table going the other way, but I wanna make sure that you have access to seeing how these can also be written going downward. Okay, so as I'm writing this, I have 1/2 to 3. The reason why it has an X and a Y is because you can graph proportional relationships. So we can actually take the X value and put it on a grid and the Y value on the grid and see if it forms a proportional relationship. So when we're comparing X and Y, we're looking to see if their values are equal. So I have 1/2 and 3, 1 and 6. When X is 3/2 and 9. And then the last one is 2 and 12. So I want to know, do these form a proportional relationship? So the way that we're going to look at this is we're going to compare their values. So I'm going to take X, which is 1/2, and it is related to 3. And I'm going to compare those two. So just like we did in our last, where we had 10 to 18, we are going to take this and we are going to divide 1/2 divided by 3. So 1/2 divided by 3. So when we get 1/2 of 3, we're taking this, we can just say it like this. So 1/2 divided by 3/1. We know keep, change, flip, right? So we're gonna keep, change, flip. And where we keep, change, flip, we have 1/2 times 1/3, which equals 1/6. So the value of this ratio right here is 1/6. That's the value of the ratio. Okay. Now we want to know, when I have a ratio that looks like this, 1/6, and I write it as a fraction, I get 1/6. 1/6, 1/6. So far, the values in this grid, in this table, are proportional. So far, we're seeing that when we have 1/2 of 3, 1/2 compared to 3 and 1/6, we have the same ratio, the same value. So this would start to form a straight line if we were graphing it on a graph. Now we're gonna look at 3/2. So I'm gonna take 3/2, compare it to 9. But when I write this as a fraction type ratio, I put 3/2 divided by 9. This is weird. We don't ever write fractions over a fraction, so that's why it only works right now because it's a ratio. Then we're gonna actually say 3/2 divided by 9. So 3/2 divided by 9/1. So now we can do the division to see what answer we get to see if this is proportional. So we have to do keep, change, flip again. Good old chicken math. All right, so we're gonna keep it. We're gonna change it and we're gonna flip it upside down and we get 3 times 1 is 3. 2 times 9 is 18. Oh my goodness, you guys, look at this. 3 divided by 18 is 1/6. What? So we have 1/6, 1/6, 1/6. Okay, don't let us down. All right, this last one, 2 compared to 12, 2/12 And we know that 2 divided by 12 equals 1/6. So if we were to graph this, this forms a proportional relationship. That means that our graph, if we were to make a graph, it would form a straight line. So our x and our y values form a straight line. So this is proportional. So let's say if I were to go 1/2 over to 1/2 up to 3, 1 to 6, that's 1 and 1/2, right? And 9, and then this is like 2 and 12. My dots on this line would be proportional. If it were not proportional, something would happen to our graph. So not proportional graphs, they tend to do lines that are like this, or lines that maybe go like this, or lines that start here and climb there. Not proportional. This is proportional because all of the values are even. Not proportional because x and y, when you do these values, they do not form straight lines. So we're going to label this one as not proportional. Okay, there is no relationship between x and y. These have a relationship, like miles per hour, or I don't know. What am I thinking? Cost per pound, right? So like they're proportional. Each one has the same value. Over here, not proportional. So if we were comparing something, they would not be equal. Like this is, I ran and then I stopped. And then I ran some more really fast and then I stopped. And then I slowed down and then I ran really fast, right? Over here, this is a steady speed. Over here, this is like, something was really expensive. Oh, and then it went on sale. Oh, and then it's expensive again. That's what that means. This one is just the cost is the same. I can buy more for the exact same price. So that's how you know it's a proportional relationship. All right, I would like to do a try it. And the way that I want to do the try it is I just want you to tell me if the two quantities are proportional. So we're going to go back to like what we did over here. And we're just going to compare the ratios. You can put them in a table if you want to, but you do not have to. Okay, so here's our try it. And I want you to tell me, are these two ratios proportional? Okay, so you're going to tell me, are they proportional? So 9 to 3, and so 9 to 3 and 45 to 15. Okay, go ahead and hit pause right now so you don't hear me solving these problems. And then when you're ready, hit play. All right, so step one, I need to turn 9 to 3 into a fraction. And then I know that if I get this down to 1, so if I divide by 3, I can divide that one by 3, and that gives me 1/3/1. Okay, the next one I need to do is 45 to 15. So I'm going to turn this to 45/15, and then I'm going to divide. I know that I can divide, I can divide by 15 because 15, 30, 45. I was going to say 3 again, but 3 gives me 5, and that's a 5 also. So let's divide by 15 over 15, and that gives me 1, and that gives me 3. You guys, look! 3/1 is the same value as 3/1. They're equal. We have an equal value. So this means that these ratios are proportionate. Are proportional. All right, go ahead and answer your essential question. How'd you do on that one? Did you find 3/1? Okay, answer your essential question and then out in the box, tell me how you're feeling about finding proportions. Are you able to turn the fractions in or turn the ratios into fractions, reduce, and then compare? Can you do that? All right, so Cougars, if you are struggling with this, please make sure that you come back to Google Classroom and you ask me questions. If not, you have just checked off one of your 7th grade standards. Yay! All right, you may go on and do your practice work. And as always, thank you so much for your hard work today. And make it a great day, the Cougar way!